a staging site is basically an exact replica of your existing website with two key differences. One, it's not available to the public. And the second one, changes you make on your staging site have no effect on your live, public-facing website. This allows you to test out changes to your WordPress site without risking to break your live website. That means you can try new themes, plugins, code snippets, and more with zero risks. If you want a simple way to create a WordPress staging site, there is a fairly new plugin called WP Staging. It's a good option for testing out basic tweaks or checking if new plugins or themes are compatible with your current setup. For example, some more complex plugins might interfere with the rest of WordPress, causing some unexpected problems. Enabling such plugins on a staging site first is a good idea because you can check if everything is in order. WP Staging will handle this purpose flawlessly. To use this plugin on your website, you just need to install and activate it. Then, head to WP Staging tab and click on Create New Staging Site. Give your staging site a name, for example Dev or Staging, and then click Start Cloning. The process might take a few minutes depending on how large your site is. Once it's finished, you can access your staging site by clicking the Open Staging Site button here. You'll need to log in with your normal username, then you're free to start testing. You'll always be able to tell when you're on your staging site by looking at the orange admin bar. And don't worry, only users with admin accounts can access your staging site. Neither Google nor your website visitors will be able to view it. A plugin you may want to test out on your staging site is the Gutenberg Editor, which will become the core page and post editor starting WordPress 5.0, according to what they said at the latest WordCamp meeting. We will see it then. If you want to delete the staging site after you finish testing everything, you can click on Delete here in the Site Start menu on your live site. Before that, make sure you check carefully if these database tables and files are safe to delete and do not belong to your live site. Once you click the Remove button below, everything related to that staging site will be removed, including the database and the subdomain. Unfortunately, with this free version of the WP Staging plugin, I am unable to show you how to push changes to your live site, because that feature is available only in the Pro version as a one-click action. It's your decision if it will worth the money for these extra features. Which plugin or theme you think about testing on your own staging site? Let me know what you think in the comments section below. And then check out these top plugins and themes recommended for WordPress. See you in the next video.